When fishermen approached the beach at Sebastian Inlet Park, they were greeted with a stunning sight. Thousands of dead fish clogging the shore, floating on the surf.
Saw the fish jumping out there, and I thought it was going to be a really good day for fishing, and then noticed over here in the surf that they're all dead.
So many dead fish that people who have lived here for years were stunned.
Sure, I've been here 10 years, 12 years. And never saw it before in my life.
Florida Fish and Wildlife biologists arrived to assess the situation and to take water samples as people watched.
It's a little shocking, yes. I don't know if there's chemicals in the water or the temperatures that cause this.
Turns out it's neither. The fish themselves are pulling a sort of reverse lemmings behavior. Rather than leaping off a cliff to their death, they are crowding together at the shore and using up all of the oxygen in the water.
Just because there's such a large school of them, they use up the oxygen really quickly. And because they are coming closer to shore, there's not as high of a water turnover rate sometimes when you're in an area with not as much tidal flow. And that could be it, too.
The oxygen was so low that other fish were affected, too, like this 20-pound redfish. Biologists swished it through the water to get more oxygen through its gills.
Fins are starting to move.
Yeah, he's starting to...
The biologists say these fish are menhadens and that while this is unusual, this type of fish is prone to die from low oxygen.
There's still a huge school out there where if they don't swim away soon to go to an area where there's a higher oxygen level, then they are going to probably end up dying also.